Hello and welcome. Today we're going to be talking about Olga of Kiev. She was a very important woman that helped a great deal in history. Let's begin.
Olga's birthday is unknown. It is between 890 and June 5th, 925. This time was known as the Early Middle Ages, a time where Christianity was growing to spread throughout Europe. In fact, she was the first Kievan ruler to convert to Christianity. She had a grandson named Vladimir. Let's have a talk with him.
Hello, I'm grandson of Olga of Kiev, Vladimir. My grandmother, Olga of Kiev, was a very good person. She made me interested in Christianity. Because of her, I converted the whole place of whole Rus to Christianity. She was a very good person.
Olga was the regent of Sviatoslav until 964. She led the entire killing of the Dravidian tribe. We got to meet up with her husband and asked what he had to say about the tribe and her killing it.
Hello, I am Igor Kiev, Olga's husband. I am the reason that she killed the entire Dravidian tribe. Olga became very mad that she had killed me. That they had killed me, or in better words, executed me. And you know what they say, if mother is not happy, nobody is happy.
Here at the History Zone, we recreated what happened at Kiev and the Dravidian tribe. Keep in mind though, that this was not exactly what happened, it was just a recreation. However, viewer discretion is advised. Go.
I'll avenge you, my love. Don't worry. I'll be back.
You'll never get your revenge. Instead, you're gonna marry one of us.
Consider this our engagement.
What are you doing?
I guess things got too heated.
I just want to confirm that the previous clip was a dramatization. Okay, let's move on. Olga of Kiev had a huge contribution to Christianity.
She had such a contribution to the spread of Christianity that she became venerated as a saint. And with a pretty face like Olga's, is there any surprise?
In fact, she became one of the first saints. Saints are given that title because of their holiness. It reminds people that the church is holy and can never stop being holy. Okay, let's take a quick intermission. I forgot to wash my hands. Oh, I didn't see you there. Let's talk about how Olga changed the role of women. Follow me. Although it is not known with surety, women in hunter-gatherer times were theorized to be equal to their male counterparts. As agrarian society developed, women were theorized, and with history showing the proof, to become less equal to men.
Men would protect the land and women would work the land. This continued throughout time, but as the Middle Ages came to an end and humanist ideas popularized, the role of women changed and slowly became equal to men. Olga of Kiev was a major contributor to this change. She led her people in a time of need and drove out enemies that previously were undefeated.
Today we learned about Olga of Kiev and a fearless ruler who protected her people and slaughtered an entire tribe in one command. We learned about her husband and how he contributed to this deathly campaign, no matter how little he contributed. We talked about her grandson, Vladimir, and her influence on him. I'm Luke from the History Zone, and we'll see you next time when we talk about Joseph Stalin.